Do you follow fashion trends? I'm Sheila, and this is Chic and Confident, a channel for women over 50 who want to dress well with ease. For the best style tips, hit the subscribe button and ring the bell, and you'll be notified every Tuesday when I upload a new video. Before we get started, I just want to say this video is not for you if you love to shop, if you find styles easy to fit, everything kind of fits you, if you love trendy items, and if you have lots of money to spend. Today's video is about how following trends makes having a wardrobe you really love and easy to get dressed more difficult. And I'm going to explain this as we go on. I'm not saying you shouldn't wear trendy pieces. They're great as long as you know how to incorporate them into your wardrobe and that you don't have too many of them. Trendy items are great as long as they are well chosen and they fit really well into your wardrobe. The first problem with trendy items is being able to mix and match them into your wardrobe. And the thing about trendy items is they're usually different, and that makes it even more difficult to match them into your wardrobe. If you're really good at mixing and matching, that's great, so you'll be able to incorporate those trendy items into your wardrobe. But if you aren't, it's going to cause you frustration and confusion. And if you don't know how to blend those items into your wardrobe, you're going to end up with a closet that's full of clothes that you don't wear. Maybe you'll wear them once or twice, but then they're just going to be hanging there. And it's going to cost you a lot of money, it's going to cost you a lot of time if you have to go shopping for these items, because your closet is going to be full of trendy items. Something else I've noticed is that every season trends are different, and a lot of those trends aren't wearable trends. So for example, the bralette. I don't know about you, but I won't be wearing that. And then for example, there's midriff flossing. That's something else I won't be wearing unless I wear it in a way like this. There are ways you can wear it where it looks trendy and looks good as well. But a lot of those trends are unwearable. Another trend for 2021 is maxi dresses. That's certainly a wearable trend and will take you from year to year, so it's great to incorporate into your wardrobe. Another one is black and white. So you can always wear black and white, it's timeless. When they show it on the runway, it's more creative, but you can use it in your own way to make it the way it suits you. Number three. Every season there are seasonal colors, and you probably have noticed the Pantone seasonal colors every year. And you've also probably noticed that when you go into a store or when you look at the clothes online, there are certain colors that are available and a lot of colors that aren't. So what you'll find are mostly seasonal colors. And this is great if you know your colors and you'll know which ones to avoid. But if you don't know your colors and you buy the colors for the season, you could end up with a wardrobe with a lot of colors that don't match, don't go together, and then you're really going to be into frustration. The way to remedy this is to know the colors that look best on you, so you won't buy colors that aren't good for you and end up with that over color problem. The fourth problem is that when you buy trends, sometimes you don't think about how that trend is going to work into your wardrobe, how it's going to, like I said, the colors, how it's going to fit in, but also if it's going to suit your body shape. So there are lots of trends that are really nice and they look great on someone else, look great on models, but will it look great on you? So that's something else you need to know. Will this trend look great on my body shape? And that requires knowing your body shape. And I'm going to leave links in the description box below, both for my color guide and my how to dress for your body shape guide. Number five is your personal style. If you get in the habit of buying too many trendy items, your personal style will go out the window. And knowing your personal style is one of the best ways to dress well. When you know your personal style, you won't be dragged off to trends. You will know exactly which trend you can put in your wardrobe and which trend you should leave out. That is, which trend will reflect your personal style and which one won't. So now that I've told you what not to do, here's what you can do instead. Have a wardrobe plan. And that means before you do that, you need to know your body shape, you need to know your colors, you need to know your personal style, know who you are. Then have a plan for all those styles that are going to suit you. And the next thing when it comes to trends is to choose the trends that are going to put some fun and pizzazz into your wardrobe. So this is where I think trends do their best. Being able to put some fun in your wardrobe, being able to make something different, change what you already have, create new outfits with just the addition of a few new things. That's where trends belong. When each new season comes along and you're looking for a new trend, here's what you can do. Go to your favorite designer, go to their website, and just look at all the different things they have. So your favorite designer will be the styles that you love, that whenever you buy them, they usually fit you and they just kind of, they feel good. So go to their website, look at all the new things they have, and then from there, it will be much more easy to find trends, the new items to update your wardrobe. And if you'd like some personal guidance on how to put your wardrobe together, you can find a link down below and set up a call with me where we can chat and talk about how I might be able to help. Thank you for watching, and if you've enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and keep on styling.